was going to take some shots to a bunny. But when I look back, look what I got.
Hi, Serkut here. Was not planned, but I couldn't say no. For other words, I had to shoot those on the last day of the season. Not on the 31, but on the 30. I got myself a new piece of ground, more or less 4,000 acres, and the owner asked me if I shoot deer. Of course I say yes, but I explained to him that the doe season was almost finished, and he says, but you still manage to get a couple, do you? I was like, well, I can try, and I did try. So I arrived at the farm the first time out stalking. We were out the night before and shot a few rabbits, and I spot the park was really bad with doe, like.
Right. Let me fill you in the situation. I'm in a new permission, well over 4,000 acres of land, and it's the first time out at daytime for a stalk. We was in last night, and in that particular place we spot well over 10 roe in one spot. Fucking crazy. Well, I just come up to the edge, I park the car, and I take a chance in that spot. Well, from the distance I spot about 5. So let's get close. Let's get a stalk.
I decided, yeah, I'm gonna do a stalk. I drag myself along the grass, the ditch, half snow, half mud. But I was getting closer and the phone rang. It was a farmer again, saying that I could easy shoot in another bit of land that doesn't belong to him, but he spoke with the owner and it's okay. So I just added more ground to that one. So it was all good, but the deer heard my phone and bugger off. My fault, really. I should have put the phone in silence. But then I got them that footage. Was not all of them, because when I arrived, I saw at least 7 or 8. Some of them run straight into the trees, others just stay. It's a nice buck. That's a nice buck. No, that's a nice buck. That's a nice buck. But yeah, I have to stand and wait and wait and wait. Then they slowly start creeping themselves into the woods. So I thought, well, I was not in the best position. So I walk right back and I went all the way around. Wasn't there really a lot of a breeze, but it was a bit of a breeze. I could see the windmill was quite static, but was moving. So I went all around and I sit myself in a grass park, right in the grass in the open. And I wait and I wait. I move position and I wait and I wait. And then I decide, well, getting bored. And I did that. Well, that. That shot was about 150, 160 yards. The 243 was over the top. Bagger. So I reload. And I was going to choose another one. And I was going to choose the top one that you can see on the snow. When, before I press the trigger, let's look what happened behind me. And this, I saw that, and I cannot believe it. So I learned something, you know. Doesn't matter where you are. I was not hiding. I liked the camo, what I was wearing. I was flat on the ground, and I was facing the wrong way. I just had to turn myself around, grab my rucksack to put my rifle on top. I didn't have any tripod with me, so I have to take off my binos, put on the ground to put the camera on top. The footage is not the best, but it's some footage. So that was, I was very, very pleased. I was pleased. The first shot, the first one, hit it hard, but she just went and just jumped the fence and was dead. Was dead. The second one was on the spot, as you see.
Right. It paid off. I'm laying the ground in a grass park. And I was going to take some shots to a bunny. But when I look back, look what I got. Job done. One jumped the fence and went to the other side. Need to find it. Let's see what I can do. Got two down.
No more footage after that because I have to clear before getting dark. So yeah, basic was that. I was pleased. The farmer was pleased. And I'll be back for more. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching and catch you later. Bye for now.